Hello, I'm Charlie Spann, Mason's Chief Information Officer. Welcome to the annual IT Security Awareness Training, which is designed to help you understand and protect the valuable data entrusted to us at George Mason University. In this video, we'll cover the different classifications of data, the necessary protections, and your role and responsibilities in handling this data securely. The Mason community trusts us with their valuable information, and it's our responsibility to ensure the security and privacy of the data we handle.
At Mason, data security and privacy considerations are critical across various domains. Data plays a vital role in our administrative, academic, and research objectives. We broadly classify our data into two major categories: public data and protected data. As the name implies, public data is intended for public use and is usually freely available. Examples include online university directories, directions, parking maps, organization charts, and more. These may still have some safeguards in place to protect from malicious or inadvertent alteration, but usually have fewer or no access restrictions, and the lifecycle may be managed in a relatively discretionary manner. Protected data requires special handling to ensure its confidentiality and integrity. This involves access control, encryption, data retention, archiving, and destruction processes. Within protected data, there are two subcategories: highly sensitive data, or HSD, and restricted data. Highly sensitive data is of the utmost importance to protect. If compromised or disclosed inappropriately, it can have financial, reputational, privacy, compliance, and other similar impacts both for the subject and the university. Examples of HSD include social security numbers, dates of birth, driver's license information, visa or passport information, and background check information. System and technology-related information, such as passwords, PINs, cryptographic private keys, network diagrams, system configurations, and documentation related to high-risk systems, such as banner and enterprise CUI systems, would also be considered highly sensitive and must be protected with the highest level of safeguards as defined in the university policies, standards, and procedures. Financial data, such as cardholder data associated with credit cards and financial aid scholarship information, also falls under the highly sensitive data category. These types of data require a high level of security protection as defined by the U.S. Department of Education. Restricted data, by its very nature or regulation, are private or confidential and must not be disclosed except to a previously defined set of authorized users. Examples include confidential donor information, employee performance evaluations, some research data, minutes from confidential meetings, accusations of misconduct, and any other information that has been identified by the university, its contractors or funding agencies, or federal or state regulations as private or confidential and not to be disclosed. Data defined as confidential by the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act, or FERPA, also falls into this category. For more information on FERPA-related data, you can consult the registrar's website. Now that we understand the different classifications of data at Mason, let's talk about our responsibilities. As a steward, owner, user, or custodian of the data, you play a crucial role in maintaining its security. First and foremost, if you don't have a business requirement to handle highly sensitive or restricted data, you should not have access to it. If you come across such data without a valid justification, talk to your direct supervisor or the information security team. Methods such as de-identifying or sanitizing the data can be used to reduce risk. It is important that you review and familiarize yourself with the data stewardship policy. Authorization to view and use highly sensitive data is controlled and approved by data owners or their delegates, known as data custodians. They are responsible for managing authorization and access control processes. There are audit and access review responsibilities associated with this, and the data owner or their delegate must have documented processes for managing authorization and access control. One key aspect of these processes is to provide an initial justification for granting access to individuals. This justification helps us determine if the person truly needs access to the data for legitimate business purposes. There must be a well-defined process to provision and deprovision access as roles change and staff members join or leave the department or the organization. This ensures that access privileges are aligned with current responsibilities. It's not enough to establish these processes and forget about them. Regular review is essential. At a minimum, an annual review must be conducted to ensure that access permissions remain appropriate and necessary, and the results of the review must be documented. It is recommended that the application, service, or system used for storing protected data can log access-related activities. In many instances, such as for highly sensitive data, this capability is a requirement. As a data owner or their delegate, it is your responsibility to understand this logging capability and ensure that access logs are reviewed periodically. By doing so, we can identify any potential security incidents or breaches and take appropriate action. It's crucial to familiarize yourself with the regulatory requirements applicable to the type of data you handle. Compliance with university policies, Commonwealth law, and federal regulations is essential to protect the data entrusted to you. Remember, if you don't have a business requirement to store or operate highly sensitive or restricted data, you should not have access to or be working with it. Many university applications have already been reviewed and approved to store protected data. If you're unsure about whether an application, service, or system is approved for storing protected data, always seek clarification and request approval when necessary. It's better to be safe and compliant. If you have any questions or need additional information, please contact the IT Risk and Compliance Team at itrc@gmu.edu or contact the IT Security Office. They're here to support you and ensure our data remains secure.
Congratulations on completing this training. You now have a better understanding of the different classifications of data at Mason, how to protect them, and your responsibilities as a custodian of this valuable information. Remember, protecting data is a shared responsibility. By staying informed and following the guidelines provided, we can ensure the security, privacy, and integrity of the data entrusted to us. Now it's time to take a short quiz and acknowledge your understanding of the information covered today.